looking at me on social media, you wouldn't think that like anything is going on behind the scenes, and you only see 15 seconds of my life on TikTok. It's really not that much. I'm Abby Roberts. I started out in TikTok and social media, and now I'm venturing into the world of music. Just released my very first single, Paramaniac. And yeah, the response has been amazing so far. So it's a fun journey that I'm starting on. Started out on social media when I was 11 years old. So my very first video was like me doing my sister's makeup, and it was literally just us like messing about as kids. Makeup was terrible. I did that just as a joke, and it kind of blew up, which caught me a little bit off guard. But as I got older, I kind of wanted to use it in a more artistic way and expressive way, and TikTok really helped me to like show that. And I think it was really fun when I first joined, because there was like all these challenges that I could mix my makeup abilities with and mix into like comedy and all these different genres, and I didn't feel limited to just one specific like airbrushed little box. I've always like been passionate about music, but I'm not gonna lie, when I was growing up, I was like a very, very shy little child. And I didn't like singing in front of like other people, but I'd always like sing around the house and stuff. We're going to see Blondie this year.
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I'm so excited. I think it was like on my 19th birthday, actually, I had like my first meeting with a real producer and sat in the studio for the first time and started writing songs. And I think the first year of writing was kind of just a bit more about figuring out myself as an artist. It's not something that I'd like grown up doing a whole lot of, or even knew people who were really into music and could teach me about it. So it was really like a learning process to begin with. I'm just looking for some stuff for my sister.
Yeah.
She really likes Beatles and stuff. The songwriting part is probably my favourite part of it, because it's where I get to express myself. I do like a lot of my shopping at thrift stores and like on Depop and that kind of stuff. I think you can find like more unique pieces and stuff. Like this Ed Hardy jacket is actually like thrifted. So Paramaniac, I actually really just like the word maniac, and I wanted to put it in a song because I think it sounds like sick. But I came across Paramaniac, which really resonated with me. It means like someone who likes to complain a lot. And I just felt like it described me very well. It's kind of this song that's just a bit of a stream of consciousness, a bit of a rant, a bit of a vent. I talked a lot on social media about like struggling with my identity and stuff, and you know, anxiety has been a big part of my life, so I wanted to use Paramaniac as like a vessel to really talk about that and how it's affected me personally, because I think that from the outside, looking at me on social media, you wouldn't think that like anything is going on behind the scenes, and you only see 15 seconds of my life on TikTok. It's really not that much. There's definitely some indie rock in there. I love like Arctic Monkeys, and Bieber Doobie as well is like a big influence and someone who I'm listening to right now. Growing up, I listened to a lot of Lana Del Rey. So she's definitely like a huge influence on me, especially lyrically. I really like how she like portrays herself emotionally in her songs. My style is something that I feel like is very dependent on my mood and how I'm feeling that day. If I want to be a little spicy, I'll spice it up a little bit. If I want to stay in my sweatpants all day, then I'll do that. And I think that's really showcased like the best in the Paramaniac music video as well. There was all these different characters and stuff, and that was kind of to show all the different sides of Abby, if you will.
Go take a selfie.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I'd love to.
Thank you.
Oh, no worries. Oh, thank you so much. Sorry, stop it. I think there's like quite a stigma with TikTokers going into music. But for me, it was about telling my story and like getting that across. I wanted to like push myself artistically, and music has been like a great outlet for that and a great like form of therapy as well. And even if like anybody else has their opinion about it, like it's helped me a lot personally, and hopefully it can help other people as well. And that's really been my goal with it, rather than just to like have a quick song out that like I'm not attached to or anything. Pink Champagne is probably like one of the most like lovey-dovey tricks, I guess. It's about more post-breakup, I guess, so there's a little bit of saltiness in there as well. To create more music and create better music. This is only like my very first project, so obviously it's not going to be like, wow, this is Abby Roberts, like the fully fledged artist or whatever. It's very much like a journey, and I'm excited to learn and get better at it.